Cocktail before dinner?
Yes, but here's a Gibson.
Right away.
Well, here we are again.
Yes.
Do you recommend anything?
The brook trout. A little trouty, but quite good.
So? Brook trout. Anyway, I think.
Yes.
I know, I look vaguely familiar.
Yes.
You feel you've seen me somewhere before?
Mm-hmm.
Funny how I have that effect on people. It's something about my face.
It's a nice face.
You think so?
I wouldn't say it if I didn't.
Oh, you're that type.
What type?
Honest.
Not really.
Good, because honest women frighten me.
Why?
I don't know. Somehow they seem to put me at a disadvantage.
Because you're not honest with them?
Exactly.
Like that business about the 7 parking tickets?
What I mean is, the moment I meet an attractive woman, I have to start pretending I've no desire to make love to her.
What makes you think you have to conceal it?
She might find the idea objectionable.
Then again, she might not.
Think how lucky I am to have been seated here.
Well, luck had nothing to do with it.
Fate?
I tipped the steward $5 to seat you here if you should come in.
Is that a proposition?
I never discuss love on an empty stomach.
You've already eaten.
But you haven't.
Don't you think it's time we were introduced?
I'm Eve Kendall. I'm 26 and unmarried. Now you know everything.
Tell me, what do you do besides lure men to their doom on the 20th Century Limited?
I'm an industrial designer.
Jack Phillips, Western sales manager for Kingby Electronics.
No, you're not. You're Roger Thornhill of Madison Avenue, and you're wanted for murder on every front page in America. And don't be so modest.
Oops.
Oh, don't worry. I won't say a word.
How come?
I told you. It's a nice face.
Is that the only reason?
It's going to be a long night.
True.
And I don't particularly like the book I've started.
Ah.
You know what I mean?
Let me think. Yes, I know exactly what you mean. That's my trademark, rot.
Roger O. Thornhill. What does the O stand for?
Nothing. I'd invite you to my bedroom if I had a bedroom.
A roommate?
Nothing, not even a ticket. I've been playing hide and seek with the Pullman conductor ever since the train left New York.
How awkward for you.
Yes, isn't it? No place to sleep.
I have a large drawing room all to myself.
That doesn't seem quite fair, does it?